Hi my loves, thank you so much for visiting my channel. This is actually a timeless collective reading for the sign of Capricorn.
Travel came out, okay? Some of you could be wanting to get away. Yeah, you have here snake and sadness. All right, so right away, and here's the evil eye card. Yeah, yikes. Okay, so this doesn't have to be bad. This doesn't have to be doom and gloom. But some of you right now, you could be wanting to get away. Some of you are realizing that you have some type of low vibrational, like negative energy around you. Maybe someone is sending you the evil eye. You could be sad finding out who this is coming from. Third party is here. Jeez. Sad news. So already, ouch. So some of you, there's some type of third party situation going on. Now, a third party situation doesn't always have to mean that this is related to some type of love situation or another person. For some, sometimes a third party can be, it can be anyone. It could be a friend, a family member. It could be distance. It could be, it's just some type of blockage, some type of challenge that you are facing here. Something that's interfering in your life, in your business. Some of you definitely have someone who has been watching you. I really feel like this is an energy though that is coming to an end, or it has come to an end, and maybe you are in a period of recovery right now. Honestly, the snake can definitely signify something that is not good, and we have the sadness card here. So it's like being sad, disappointed, or regretful about a situation. This could be your energy or someone else's. But with the snake card here, this is also saying that the snake sheds skin. It's time for you to shed a layer of old skin and move forward. I heard as I was sitting here preparing for the reading that either this is your portion or it is not your portion. Now I've kind of been meditating on what that means, because what I've noticed lately is, obviously we're in a new year. Mercury was in retrograde and is going direct. We're in Aquarius season now. Aquarius is all about a lot of forward thinking. Okay, that's an air sign. So news, travel, communication. Mercury just went direct. We had the full moon in Cancer recently. So we're starting this year out with a lot of major endings of cycles, okay? To me, I celebrate the new year really like the lunar new year. So closer to spring, when things really start to bloom and blossom. I think that right now, some people, you're really realizing that you have to clear away things from past years, several years, decades maybe, but especially things that you went through in like 2022. I just heard 2017. So like from 2017, like the last 5 to 7 years of your life, you're clearing things up. So you could be feeling like a little sad because as you reflect on these things, you kind of have to assess and evaluate the situation from all angles. So you're seeing your part that you played in the situation, how other people did you wrong, but also there's an opportunity here for growth. You're gaining a lot of wisdom here. Some of you during Mercury retrograde, if this is related to a romantic situation, you may just be facing the fact that there is some type of love triangle here. And maybe this is something that's not going to end. Maybe there's a third party person that has been sending you the evil eye, or someone has been sending you the evil eye, so that it's more difficult for you to move into new connections, you know. But maybe it's time for you to really just rest and retreat, try to get away, find something new, fun, adventurous. It's like you're taking a new journey, and this journey is going to take you to the next level. Burnout is here. So, wow, what the heck is going on? So some of you right now, you may just be feeling a little burnt out when it comes to relationships. This is friendships, partnerships, relationships of all sorts and kinds. I just see like self-care is needed. Everyone right now needs to really work on taking care of themselves. But there's a strong message here. You don't need to get to the point of canceling people out. But you may, when you can't change people, you change people. When you can't change people, you change people. Some of you need to get out of your current social circle because this could be affecting your finances. Even like maybe there's people you hang out with that you work with or you've done business with, but you're just not on the same energetic frequency. You don't have the same level of consciousness and awareness as these people. Okay, love offer is here. Some of you, you have a very like jealous, envious person too that's a third party. You could be dealing with someone and they have an ex that is sending you the evil eye because they're very sad, disappointed, and in regret that someone is coming towards you who's actually making the decision to change. I'm seeing that strongly here. Some of you definitely have a new love offer here. You could have met someone online, okay? Or online doesn't have to be a dating site. It could be someone who has some type of strong online, like social media presence. They could be an influencer, something like that, you know, or maybe you're doing business with this person. You could have someone that's coming towards you, someone in their life, whether it's a friend, family, or a lover, could possibly really be sending you the evil eye, projecting a lot of negative energy onto you. Because you have this offer coming. You right now are for sure like a magnet for a lot of success. But I feel that for some of you, it's saddening that you are currently becoming such a magnet for success in your life. But some people, love is truly lacking. I get where you're burnt out. You're tired of doing everything on your own, perhaps. You may start to kind of do like ghost people. Like these sudden just disappearing acts. Or you may feel like you just need to cut off all communication. For those, there's a strong energy coming through though about a love offer. For some of you, you have someone that is presenting an offer to you. Maybe they're trying to get to know you. They may have recently ghosted or blocked a person. There may be a situation where they haven't fully gotten closure, or the other person feels like this cycle isn't closed and they're very angry and upset. So you may want to just be mindful of that. Yeah, but you have celebration and manifestation, answers, learning. Yeah, and the moon here and creativity. So you're for sure tapping into your creativity now, but this is just like the removal of a lot of illusions here, a lot of secrets, a lot of the reading yesterday, I was talking a lot about the shift in the divine masculine collective. I don't know exactly when Mars goes direct, but Mars has been in retrograde for a long time. So whether you're male or female, you consider yourself feminine or masculine, there's a huge shift that's happening with the masculine energy. So a lot of people who typically are very artistic, creative, intuitive are starting to take a more logical, structured, analytical approach to situations. Our divine masculine collective is truly waking up now, and you will have a lot of karmic energies that are extremely upset by this awakening that's happening. You do have a lot of masculines who are choosing to take their divine path. And a masculine can be a male or a female. They're choosing to walk away from things that no longer serve them. They're choosing to move out of homes, to travel, to relocate. They're sick and tired of being sick and tired. They're getting rid of the third party energies and things like that, whatever the interference may be. This is causing that backfire domino effect that I've been talking about, where people get very upset when you set boundaries. And you begin to move in a different direction that does not include them. This, for some of you, it could be you, or like I said, it could be someone that is in your energy that you may currently be involved with. I just want to get the regular tarot. So yeah, there's a lot happening here. You're shedding a lot of old layers of skin though. You and people that you're connecting with, a lot of you are meeting people who are a part of your current, like your soul family and tribe, people that you are a vibrational match for. And you're gonna find that a lot of you, you're healing with somebody. I've definitely been getting that energy where a lot of people are gonna start walking into your life and they are very similar to you, or they've had a similar journey. Back to what I was saying before about that, it's not your portion. It's something that I heard either it is your portion or it's not. So it's very clear something is for you, and there it's very clear that something is not for you. But I'm also getting with whatever is happening energetically in the cosmos, the way that the energy is shifting, a lot of things, it's this extreme deja vu-like energy that I've been experiencing even in my personal life, where you will see that certain things are being presented to you again. So it's like a new cycle, but the experience may seem very much like the last experience. I feel like this is a major test to see how well you can discern. And also it's like a fear factor thing here. When something is presented to it, for instance, in the when it comes to matters of the heart and love, where so many people ruin themselves because love is needed if you want success in other areas of your life. A lot of people get hurt in relationships, whether it's friendships, family, or romantic relationships, and they sort of like cancel off love. They dive into work, or they find everything to keep themselves busy except them opening their heart again. Some people now, you're going to have situations that are going to come back. In some instances, it's people, but not necessarily people. These are energies that are coming back. And you have to decide, do you want to move forward with this energy or a new energy? But when it comes to it being your portion, some things really are meant to be in your life. It doesn't look like what you want it to be, but it's meant to be in your life. But you're meant to have a certain wisdom and knowledge in how you handle it. So in the past, you may have had to clear a lot of karma in a situation. A similar situation may present itself to you again now, but it's a lot better because now you have the wisdom and the knowledge to handle this situation differently. So you may find yourself, like I said, like in your work or in relationships, it seems like, wow, like I've been here, I've done this before. Also just becoming more spiritually inclined, you're gonna meet soulmates along your journey as well, and you're just gonna recognize these people. You've crossed paths with them before, but you need to be discerning, but you have to make sure you're not afraid. You can miss out on a lot of opportunities by thinking that everything is a repeat of the past. It's similar to the past, but it's not the same. Because you have to keep in mind, if it's presenting itself again, there's still some type of lesson for you to learn, or there's some offer or opportunity for you to gain. See? Two of Wands. See? It's taking action. And this has, for some of you, a lot to do with you connecting with somebody. Justice. This is Spirit saying that energetically, spiritually, something here has been balanced out. And honestly, it is safe for you to love. It is safe for you to move forward. It doesn't matter what the situation looks like. It's safe for you to move forward. This is you learning the importance of your own like self-awareness and know if you're protected, you're protected. You have to start knowing that God, your guides, your angels, they're not going to let certain things come towards you or allow certain weapons that are formed against you to prosper. So you can't operate out of fear. A lot of you, it really is time for you to pursue that business. It really is time for you to pursue that relationship and come out of hermit mode. You have to stop ghosting everything and every person because you've been surrounded by snakes. Spirit is saying now you need to shed the weight from the snakes. Something is for sure being balanced out, though, so that you and someone can come together. It's something strong here, but it requires a lot of strong faith, hope, and courage to be the Empress. To love, I keep saying this, to look at this. Are you willing to give love another shot? This is not necessarily you giving that person another shot, but Spirit is saying here with the World card, you have graduated. You've learned some type of lesson here. It is safe for you to go out and do something again. Like the coast is clear. The World card is here. You have the Two of Wands, the Two of Cups, the Empress, and the World. It is safe for you to love. It's a very, very strong connection here is undeniable. It's unbreakable. This is what is either in your life or it's waiting for you, but you have to have the courage to accept it. Empress, you've grown. You're manifesting a lot, but you need that love to manifest the true desires of your heart. You need that. It's a requirement. And this is what so many people, a lot of people don't talk about this. On the healing journey, much of it is you being separated and in isolation. A lot of people are now moving to the next level of their journey where you have to see now that, okay, you cannot be so engulfed in healing that you forget to actually go out and live. You can't be stuck in just existing in healing and being focused on the evil eye, the sadness and the snakes in your life and this and that, that you give up and you forget to actually go out and celebrate, to create, to manifest. That something is no longer your portion. You have a new portion of blessings that are being handed to you. But you have to say, okay, I'm graduating. A lot of people, they don't return back to love once they've been hurt by it so bad. Whether this is love of people in the church, your family, your friend group, a mentor hurts you, a parent hurts you, your best friend, a lover, an ex-spouse, whomever. A lot of people, they get so deeply wounded that they just never go back to it. And Spirit is saying, you're going to have to return back to that thing that hurt you the most. And honestly, a lot of people have been hurt by love. This is the harder part of the journey. Facing yourself and your real truth. That maybe you're afraid of love, but there you have something very stable and secure. You have the real deal here. It's being placed in your lap. Queen of Pentacles, Ace of Pentacles. A lot of you, you're going to have to come to, yeah, look at that, in the Knight of Pentacles. Somebody is coming towards you with an offer, and it is actually the gateway, dang, to the Four of Wands. Are you going to accept it? You cannot walk around here with a closed heart forever and keep wondering, well, where are my pentacles? Where is my offer? Are you aligning yourself with these offers is the question. Are you aligning yourself with success, stability, new offers and celebrations? A lot of the energies around us sometimes can be dark and they can come off as toxic, but there's something here that is worth you putting an investment in. You've already planted good seeds and it took a lot of patience. Again, maybe 7 years, the last, 7 years, maybe even longer, 4 to 7 years, you've been working to invest on something here. But what I'm seeing is stability and security is not a problem for a lot of people, but you're tired of people in your life ghosting you, or you're tired of feeling rejected, or you're tired of dealing with the lack of closure in situations and being burnt out where you feel like you're taking on too much. You're supposed to be going into the next part of your journey. You have to have love in order for it to work. Just, there's no other way to put this. So you're being presented with situations now that are really testing you. I said it the other day, what you see isn't always what you get. See, a lot of you sometimes will look at a situation that comes towards you. It comes towards you slowly. It doesn't, the gift doesn't always come wrapped up the way that you want it to, but it's the gift for sure. It is for sure the gift. This is you changing that conditioning, your perception is creating your reality. And if you don't understand the importance of you changing how you perceive situations, then you will continuously manifest a reality that you're not comfortable in. Once again, you have to go back to something that hurts you and give it another shot and trust that you have the wisdom now to deal with that situation better than you did before. Some of you, this is a person that's coming back, but for some of you, you have an energy that's coming back because that is your portion. So you could have a person in the past that you're like, oh, that person was karmic to me. Well, if someone was karmic to you, you were karmic to them. meaning both of you were supposed to teach each other a lesson. A lot of people are wrapping up these cycles. You and another person, you taught each other lessons, and it's now preparing you for what is truly your portion. But the situation that comes into your life now is going to seem very similar to that past situation. But the outcome can be different now because you have the tools and the resources to manifest a new reality. I hope this makes sense. So some of you need to be careful with, because I see it happen. Oh, I'll never date that sign. I'll never date this type of person. I'll never date that race. I'll never date that. You're going to have to be careful with your don'ts and your nevers. That long list of all the things that you won't do, you can't do, you'll never do, you may want to go back and look over that. And be mindful of the people who are in your circle who have not reached the level of consciousness and awareness as you, who tell you not to do certain things. Be careful not to take advice from unhealed people. People who don't believe in evolution, the evolution of the soul. I told somebody yesterday, I can't agree with any person that tells me that people don't change because I'm a natural born healer. When you tell me that a person doesn't change, you're telling me that God didn't give me a gift to heal. God heals and changes us all constantly. I'm not the same person that I was 6 months ago, 6 years ago, or who I was when I was at the age of six. So how dare you tell me that a person can't change? How dare you tell me that I can't give a person grace, forgiveness, that I can't give them mercy, the same grace, mercy, and forgiveness that God gives us all? You're pretty much saying that I have no purpose as a healer when you tell me that people can't change. And a lot of people, they become so bruised, broken, and bitter by a situation that left them scorned that they never go back out in the world to embrace that thing again. And that keeps you in a victim mentality. Love is not supposed to hurt, but when you're not in the right situation, it can bring about pain. But I always say, if it breaks your heart, it fixed your vision. You see now how to do it differently. There's things that's going to be presented to you, and it's not going to be in the gift wrapping that you're looking for, but it is your gift. Your pain is actually your gift. It taught you everything that you needed to know. There you have it. It's a spiritual union here. It's your portion. Some of you, the thing that you're fighting off the most, I don't want that. I don't like that type of person. I don't want this. I don't need it. I'll never do it again. It's the one thing that you need to be embracing. Because if you even think about when it comes to a twin flame, you cannot run from your own darkness. That shadow aspect of that person is like your shadow in a human body outside of you. So when you keep running away from that person or not, I see things more energetically based. It's not just a person. It has nothing to do with their face, the name, their body, the energy. When you keep running away from the energy of that particular person that you've had experiences with, you're really running away from yourself. And you say that person, they're narcissistic, they're egotistical, blah, 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 blah. Well, there could be a part of you that's a bit narcissistic, or maybe you are not handling yourself the best way as an empath. Empaths and narcissists are very similar. They want the same things. They just go about getting them differently, and they have different intentions. That's it. They all want, an empath wants love, a narcissist wants love. With a double dose of praise, of course. But an empath most likely has been used and abused and desires security and stability, just like a narcissist has probably been hurt and abused and is using their ego to cover up the fact that they are extremely insecure, but they really do desire love. unfortunately, they're just incapable of truly experiencing it or giving it until they can recognize their issue. These spiritual connections, though, some of them are undeniable. They're unbreakable. And even if you don't reunite with a particular person, there is an energy that you're running away from that you actually need to embrace. Because until you embrace it, you're going to be stuck on this hamster wheel. You can see it here. This has everything to do, for sure, for some of you, with like a twin flame situation. This is for sure a twin flame situation here. Some of you have experienced like a karmic soulmate or a catalyst. They prepared you for the real deal. The real deal that's coming towards you now is probably going to be very, very similar to the last situation. Karmic situations don't always mean bad. It's the opportunity to learn. So you may have a person that comes into your life or comes back into your life, and it's very triggering. It seems just like something from the past. The difference now is their motives and intentions. And I've been talking about that a lot, because a lot of people have been at a crossroads for a long time between multiple lovers, trying to decide which way to go. You don't have to go backwards, but the energy that you experienced in the past is going to be represented to you, because that is the energy that goes with you. That's the yin and yang. This energy that you are running from is never going to be just like you. It complements you in some type of way. So you may want to stop trying to block it out. Because a lot of people, you're blocking your true feelings and emotions out for something that is your portion. Look at this. Oh my gosh. Wow. Spirit is really here today. Judgment, death. Something here is being resurrected. Something that you thought was over and done, it's not. Something ended for you to experience some type of awakening. But it's being represented to you. Again, please understand, this is energy. When I say it's being represented to you as an energy, that doesn't mean that person is coming back. That energy is coming back. Perhaps it's new and improved. Transformation is here. Do you see that? The Ten of Cups and the Ten of Pentacles. This is the real deal. Six of Wands. And this person here, through all of the challenges and adversity, they're coming back. This energy, for some of you, this is a very strong past life connection. Yeah, you can see like the pyramids here. This is, for some of you, it's, yeah. This is an ancient soul contract, a marriage, a commitment that you most likely have been fighting off. It's not going anywhere. It's not. Somebody is standing up for what they truly want, what they truly believe in, to actually free someone from being stuck in this crossroads energy. What this really is it's a message for you to surrender. That's the message. You have to surrender. Something is your portion. You're going to have to surrender to it. This is a lot of people understanding your idea of the status quo. That may just not be for you. If you're running away from people, opportunities, and connections because of what you've been taught, what you saw, what you heard, what you went through, you're going to miss out. Something here is actually for you. And you're running away from it because it requires that you face yourself. A lot of people, and I see this especially with our ladies, and I'll throw myself in this bunch. You will miss out on love because of the fact that, like I said, it requires you to be vulnerable. Most of the journey that most people have been on their spiritual path, you have been alone. You've isolated yourself from friends, from family. You've let go of all of your partners. And then you stand there and you wonder, okay, so what is next? Well, next is not coming because you won't embrace next. Before you can say what you will allow, you have a long list of everything that you won't allow. If you have standards and boundaries, great. But you cannot build up a wall so high around yourself and expect everybody to try to jump over the wall, whether it requires that they jump to their own death to try and be around you. This is in friendship, relationships, business partnerships. No matter how divine you are, no, everybody's not going to jump to their own death to be around you or with you, because you won't let the wall down. I'm seeing the collective right now. Some people have just been so wounded that the idea of going back out for another battle is scary. But that's what God gives his toughest battles to his strongest soldiers. You have to always be suited and booted and ready for battle. And this has been coming out in a lot of the readings, but for a lot of you, this is indeed like a very strong twin flame connection here. For some of you, yes, it's a person from the past, the actual person. For some of you, it's an energy from the past. It's coming back to you, maybe in a different form, a different vessel, whatever. But that energy is coming back. And it's so old and ancient, you're going to keep feeling like, wow, I've been here before. And that's where the trigger is going to come. I've been here. I've seen that. I've been with this person before. For some of you, you have. You're for sure connecting with someone that you've been with in a past life. No matter what you do, this energy is not going anywhere. It is your portion. So as long as you run away from it, you're just going to delay your own life, because it's something here that is a part of your life story. Until you give this thing a shot, you're not going to be able to pass, go and collect your $200. You're just not. Some of you, it's an energy. I'm making it a point to not say person, because an energy consciousness can separate from a vessel. There's a particular energy that you're supposed to be with. Until you're with that energy, that type of, that frequency, something here cannot, It's something here like the alchemy of two souls coming together that is so important for some of you who are chosen because of whatever your life path or mission is. Until you match with that right energy, a lot of your creation is on hold. And I speak about, you can't have a business, you won't have wealth, you won't have children. Certain things will not manifest in your life until you surrender to this energy that is your portion. And a lot of people are running from that because you were hurt by it in the past. You had to be hurt by it to gain this wisdom and knowledge now, to have this transformation. Everything is not going to be sugary and sweet. But again, that goes back to perception and how it shapes and forms your reality. You're gonna have to be a risk taker. The truth is what came out. Card number 12, the truth, and divine timing. 12:30, something could have been significant about December 30th. Something could be significant about the month of December, or something of significance may be happening within 30 days. I don't know why that timing just came out, but truth and divine timing are both out here. The truth is that something is your portion. It is true. It is real. Yes, it is rare, but it's destined to happen, but in divine timing. There's no need for you to rush this. There's no need for you to run away from it anymore. It's going to happen. Wow, this is strong. Unlimited possibilities. 19. Here's card number 44. It says home. Something, you're gonna make a home within yourself and with another person. This is something that has been orchestrated by the Most High. You can't run from it. You see here, this is like a hawk or eagle. And then you see this tree here. This is like an eagle is all seeing. being able to see something from a bigger picture point of view here for the tree of life. Understanding that, yes, everything truly does happen for a reason. Yes, whatever you're supposed to be doing, perhaps with a person, it's a lot bigger than you. You and this person, you have to connect to break a certain generational curse. You and this person, you have to connect to either blend a family or create a family. You and this person have to connect in order to build this business. Maybe it's this business that's going to break poverty off of your bloodline. But you and this person, there's something that you have to do together. And as long as you keep running away from the idea, again, not just the person, but you and this energy. Because for some of you, whenever a certain type of energy comes towards you, you run from it. You're afraid to put in the work with that type of energy. And what you're really saying is you're afraid to do the work for yourself, for your family, and your bloodline. Because you keep running away from the key to your own safe. You're going to have to surrender to this. And it's not about anything or anybody else. It's about you and whatever this energetic frequency is that you are becoming a match for, most likely with another person. Some of you are being prepared even for businesses and for children. Everything about you and your life has to change. Where you go, what you eat, what you do, who you talk to, how you protect yourself. Everything has to change. In order for you to embrace these unlimited possibilities. And it seems like the divine timing of a situation is getting close. You have here anger, struggle, inner journey, and psychic development. Wow. And here's abundance. Yeah. This is the anger. Why did I have to go through so much? This is releasing that victim mentality. Why did I have to go through so much? Why did it take me so long to start my business? Why did it take me so long to find my person? Why did it take me so long to develop my psychic gifts? You're going to have to embrace the struggles of your inner journey and stop being angry about it. Again, Mercury retrograde. This one was very significant because it was here along with that full moon in Cancer, it really shapes that connection in the home, family, relationships with mother figures, Mother Earth. You cannot keep being upset about the journey, but you're also going to have to go back to home to figure out where did you learn some of these things from and what needs to shift and change the illusions. Some people, your idea of gender roles or the status quo, it's going to have to shift in order for you to be in your mission, because your purpose is bigger than what the status quo or what society says you're supposed to do. If you embrace your purpose, your portion, God will make sure that you have an overflow of abundance. He will prepare that table for you. In front of all of your enemies. But what's the point in him preparing the table if you're not going to come down and sit at it? I just feel that it's a lot of people who are too concerned with what other people are thinking or this outdated conditioning. It doesn't serve you anymore. The who, what, when, where, why, how, like, it's really not that important. Just surrender to the transitions of your life. And this is going to require radical self-acceptance. Some of you, I'm telling you, you're canceling things off and you're canceling things out that are actually for you. And you're doing it because somebody told you that that's what you should do, or you're doing it because you didn't like how it was presented to you in the past. But if you can see that you've changed, you have to know other people can change. Energies change. It says you have all of the inner resources you need to cross whatever bridges arise on your path. And radical self-acceptance here. You guys, a lot of you could be between the ages of 29 and 37. 28, 35. Yeah, for sure. There's a strong group of you between the ages of 29 and 37. Could be any age, of course. 20, let's say 29 and 44. Radical self-acceptance. It says you are perceived the way you perceive yourself. Oh, there you have it. Exactly. How you perceive yourself and reality and your in life is what is going to manifest. You have to be very, very mindful of your thoughts, how you see things, and again, who you listen to. Going back to that full moon in Cancer that we just had, again, the mother. Some people, the womb healing that's needed around is very important. Some women, they carry trauma from their mothers, okay? Every person in your family has taught you need to go for this type of person, you need to get this type of job, you need to do it like this. And the truth is, because a lot of those people didn't have their own radical self-acceptance, because whatever they pursued, it was because they were taught to pursue that. They were conditioned to do that. Their intentions led to a lot of misalignment. A lot of people have never taken the time to understand the importance of them setting their own goals and intentions for their life. Not for everybody else, but for themselves. We're moving into love consciousness. If you want to be in an interracial relationship, do it. If you want to be in a same-sex relationship, do it. If you want to be in corporate America, do it. If you want to be an entrepreneur, do that too. You can do whatever you want to do. And you will know what is right for you because what's not right for you is very clear that you're misaligned. If everything around you is going well and yet you still feel alone, you still feel sadness. That was what the card said. You always feel like the evil eye is being projected onto you. That means that there's some type of misalignment. A lot of us are taught things that just don't work for us because of age, time, generational things, whatever. And this card here, card 31, intention, it says lacking personal direction begets confusion. And life as a pawn to someone else's game of chess. You're gonna have to stop living for other people. Some of you may be madly in love with an idea, a job, a project, a plan, or even a person, and you're not pursuing it because of what somebody else may think or say about it. You're gonna really have to let that go because all you're doing is putting your own life on hold. A lot of people will have the best thing sitting right there in their face and they will not pursue it because, oh, well, if I pursue that person, my family is going to think this. If I leave my job and I start a business and if I'm not a millionaire in 6 months, everybody's going to talk about me. But even the struggles that come in you making a decision based on your own intentions, you will be blessed. God will show you favor because you took a leap of faith. To trust yourself and most importantly, to trust God to allow Him to lead you instead of you walking down the path that somebody else is trying to create for you. And they're not even going to put on any boots to stump that path with you. I'm just saying, like, just keep that in mind. Transitions, yeah, metamorphosis is here. It says, power and strength lie within our surrender to change. Wow, I just said that. You guys, I have not touched these cards in months. Either one of these decks, none of these decks. So I always say that if you've been following my channel, whenever I get the urge to just change all of my decks, usually that means that there is a major shift in energy. And here you have moving forward voice, card number one, spirit self. And here is card number four, which says, the strength of vulnerability. True power lies at the root of a perceived weakness. Thinking that you taking a step back in a job or a business or something like that because of how other people are going to see it and see you as weak, that's not good. It's okay. And I just talked about this. If it's okay to tell somebody, I don't know what I'm doing. I need help. I need structure. I need guidance. If this isn't you, maybe this is someone around you who just is afraid to say, hey, I need help. Someone is afraid to use their voice. Check on your strong friends and family members. Because a lot of people right now, again, with this divine masculine collective, you're going to have, oh, wow. Thank you, Spirit. Some of you are going to have masculines that are going to come to you. And I'm speaking of males who are eventually going to use their voice and say, I just don't know what to do. I just don't know how to make this money. I just don't know how to move forward. I just don't know how to make things right with my family and start a new life. I don't know what to do after this divorce. And you're going to have a little bit of grace and mercy, just like people have had grace and mercy with you, because the world will oftentimes, and I feel like I'm really, really picking up a lot on our divine masculine collective now. The world sees men, especially, as they are the only ones that should offer a solution. You got some men out here who are tired. They've had to go through spiritual journeys and their metamorphosis no different than women. I'm not taking up for all of the bad guys, but let me tell you, there are some bad guys out there that are choosing now to do right. And for the feminine collective that wants to be in unions, you're going to have to find it in your heart to have some grace and mercy for people who are genuinely trying. Or else everybody's just going to be out here being divine and being alone. And there's no mission that is going to be completed that way. This is much bigger than just you. Some people are meant to be known. They have a great purpose. But yeah, they're recognizing that there has been a misalignment and it has been blocking them from moving forward. So see past the illusions. See that some people, they look fine, but they're not okay. Just like some people look like they're struggling and they're not. Everything is not as it seems. What you get is different sometimes. What you see isn't always what you get. Just like people who consider themselves earth angels and divine, feminine, masculine, or whatever, most people never saw your worth or value. Now that the crown is shining and the halo is up there and you got the wings, people are seeing it. But you have other people who are on your journey and they're coming right behind you. Make sure that you don't turn around and turn your back on good people being high and mighty. Because I'm gonna tell you what I've been noticing, this spiritual ego is bad. I've seen it a lot in the collective lately from some of our favorite readers, spiritualists, high priests. That ego is bad because people get way too high and mighty. There's always somebody better than you. And a lot of times the person that's bigger and better and greater, they're hiding in the cut. You don't see them, but they see you. And they can annihilate you if they want to. So take it easy. You're going to have people like that that's going to cross your path. People who are gods, goddesses, they have very ancient, wise souls. You can judge that book by its cover if you want to and cheat yourself out of the biggest opportunity of your life if you're not careful. We're moving into a time now where you really have to judge a person by their true character, not just their circumstances and conditions. Because circumstances and conditions change. And I say that on this channel all the time. And I say that because I know I'm a healer. I say that because I know that my life has changed and progressed. And I've seen people make drastic changes and progress in life. You don't always meet a person where you left them. And some of you, again, you're running away from good energies, new opportunities, blessings, relationships, because you're so afraid that it's going to be like it was the last time. Give it a shot. Because if you really think that, if you really say you're protected and you're divine, no matter what you do, you really shouldn't take a loss. Because even if you make a mistake, your spiritual team, they can help you to straighten that out. Oftentimes, you will be rewarded simply for having the effort to try. Some things, maybe it's not for a lifetime, but it for that season or that reason, go for it. I think that the biggest thing is to stop running away, like change your perspective or perception about karma. Karma is not good or bad. It's an experience that creates an opportunity for you to gain wisdom and knowledge. Even in the worst situations, you gain a lifelong lesson. You take that and you move forward with it. And that same or a similar situation may present itself, but now you have the key because you have the knowledge, and that's where you have the power. So stop running from everything that is presented to you. Let me see something here. It's definitely something here for some about these connections. I'm hearing that song, Usher song, "You Remind Me of Someone." That, yeah, you're gonna, for some of you, you're connected with these past life soulmates, or maybe even like a twin flame. Their soul can easily be recognized, but certain things about them is gonna be very similar to someone else from your past. Some of you who are very spiritual, you have these very, very ancient souls. Most of the people that have been in your life have been past life soulmates. Some good, some not so great. But most people that come towards you, you have some type of past with them, even if they're brand new. So what did I just say? It says here, put away the computer and play hard. It's time for you to go out. It's time for you to experience life, to really embrace it, to surrender. You need to stop working so much and go out and have fun. This is going to strengthen your relationship with yourself, because it's going to, as you meet more people and you go out and you do more stuff, you're going to have more experiences. And those are experiences are going to teach you more about discerning. You cannot lock yourself away. And oh my gosh, I see that happen so often. And I do it myself. Some people, to protect themselves, they lock themselves away and they don't experience life. They can tell you about all the doom and gloom in the world, a world that they don't live in. You have to go out and experience it. Because what you will find is that, yeah, even with all of the darkness in the world, there's still so much beauty. And when you align yourself with love and beautiful things, the darkness doesn't really faze you. It doesn't bother you. When you think about that all the time, that's what you go out and you become a magnet for. You control what you are a magnet for. Find time to go out, laugh, and enjoy yourself and other people. Make new connections. This is going to open up opportunities in love, career, and finances. There you have it. True love. True love is waiting on you. A love that is emotional, physical, and most importantly, it's unconditional. But if you want unconditional love, you can't go out with so many conditions. This person has to be like, some people, your list, you need to cut it down some. It's not even realistic anymore. And I'm not saying at all that you need not have boundaries. Continue to have boundaries, high standards, but make sure that with some of the things that you have on your list, pray to God and ask, like, are you praying for what you want, or are you praying for the things that you actually need? You should want your wants and needs to be wrapped up in one. Sometimes what you need, like I said, for some of you, even the energy, like this twin flame energy, that person could be totally different from you, but they complement you perfectly. If you're super emotional, maybe they're detached, but they offer logic. Both of you cannot sit in the floor and cry. Somebody has to have some kind of reasoning and logic. Whatever the difference may be. That's just an example, but this is learning to embrace duality and what's different. Stop running away from everything that's different. Stop running away because oh, this is different from what the people in my family have done. This is different from what my family has done. So what? Everything about you was different. So of course your life is different. Who you choose to be in your life is going to be different. Healing. Old wounds and childhood issues need revisiting. And some of you, believe it or not, when you meet a true love, this person that you can be completely vulnerable with, you and this person may find yourselves healing together. Because the truth is they're going to teach you things and make you become more enlightened about your own wounds and issues that you have not actually had the strength or the courage to revisit. That, to me, that's true love. That is true love. When you can have a good time with somebody, but you also can heal with them. You understand that, okay, we're supposed to be breaking generational curses together. We're supposed to be releasing baggage. You're not gonna ever, there's never gonna be a perfect person or a perfect time. And because so many people keep looking for perfect time and perfect person, that's why good things keep passing you by. I'm talking to myself too. I'm not preaching to a choir that's singing a song that I don't sing. Mastery. There you have it. You've already learned this spiritual lesson. So go out and live. Go out and embrace whatever is coming. You're protected. You learned enough from the last cycle that if you get in the fire and it gets too hot, you know when to get out now. You know how to stop, drop, and roll. So don't keep avoiding the fire. You know how to stop, drop, and roll. If you get caught on fire, stop, drop, and roll. But stop running from it. This requires you to use your voice and be vulnerable about the fact that you are in a transition. I will say this too, because I feel like this is like, I feel like a dating coach right now. Don't go out and tell people all your business when you meet them, but a lot of you are going to meet high-level soulmates or maybe even like an actual twin flame. The spiritual connection between the two of you, you're going to feel raw emotions. Both of you will. The connection itself is going to open you up to thoughts, feelings, emotions, and ideas, perceptions, theories, and everything else that may be somewhat new to you. Don't be afraid to say that you're afraid. Because if you tell somebody how you truly feel, you're going to quickly see how they react and respond to it. Either they're going to show up for you or they're going to ghost you. That'll tell you everything that you need. It's better for you to just be honest to see how someone is going to honestly respond as opposed to you pretending. And this is the problem. Most of us have been conditioned to pretend. Wear a mask, pretend, play the victim. Do what your mama and your grandma and so-and-so, do what they did. Even though it didn't work for them, you gotta just release yourself from that. It says here, spirit self, number one. You could be a life path, number one. This says, be who you are as you are. And you see, this like she has green hair. If you want to dye your hair, if you want to cut your hair, if you want to change, if you want to relocate, if you want to gain weight, lose weight. Like I said, if you want to be same-sex relationship, whatever you want to do that you feel is you jumping outside of the box, do it. Who's going to stop you? Because the same people who have talked about you and judged you, what have they done? They haven't helped you. They're not going to help you now. No matter what you do, people are going to have something to say. Some people will help, some people will hurt. That's just the name of the game. It's life. So you might as well do what you want to do. But if you see that your life is not going how you want, don't be afraid to find where your own misalignment is. It says miracles become normal once we fall off the aspects of our life in the same direction. I'm sorry, I said fall. I'm so sorry. Miracles become normal once we face all of the aspects of our life in the same direction. You have to face whatever it is you're running from. And a lot of people, it's love. You're running away from love. You associate love with trauma. You associate friendships, family, and close connections with chaos, jealousy, and competition. Because most of your journey, that's what it has been. But God is saying, no, I have something new for you. It may look like the past, but it's not. Of course it's going to look like the past because he's going to test you to see. Will you recognize that this is a good thing? Despite what it looks like. Because you have to think about how many people who didn't recognize you as a good thing. Because they judge what you used to look like. A lot of you, you don't look like what you've been through, right? People see you now and they think that everything is perfect. They have no idea that you had to get it out the mud and was down in the trenches for a long time. All I'm saying is honor yourself, honor other people, and pay things forward. You're going to meet other people on your journey who don't look like what they've been through, or they don't look like what they're going through. Maybe it's time for you to give somebody a leg up. Maybe it's time for you to be a person's friend that's in need. Because at some point, I'm sure there's been somebody there that had a kind word, some information, some advice, or something for you. You're going to keep being blessed. Because God is putting you in a position now to be a blessing to others. Don't keep your gifts and your blessings just to yourself. Because your purpose is to go out and be a blessing to others. Some of you, your unions are supposed to bless others. Just by letting people see that true love really does exist. But if you never go out and you run away from every person and every connection, you're not really in your purpose. So try to work smarter instead of harder, but go out and enjoy life, embrace it, experience it. Don't just exist. I'm going to get, this is our spiritual message deck. See what it says and I'll close out. Wow. Cutting the deck. What do we have? Relationships and hope. A lot of you are hoping, wishing and praying for a good relationship. They're around you, but you won't embrace them. Because your heart is still guarded from the last relationship that hurt you. It says, relationships are just mirror images of your own life. How you feel and treat yourself, as well as how you react and respond to different situations and people around you. Be aware that every relationship is an opportunity for soul growth. Didn't I just say this? There is no good or bad karma. Everything is going to help you to ascend. If the fire gets hot, stop, drop, and roll. But it still taught you something. I see a lot of people that just, no, this is a karmic coming towards you. You can deal with somebody for a week and they can teach you something that's going to help you next year. Be okay with meeting people and being and having to let them go. But a lot of people deal with rejection and abandonment issues and separation anxiety. You won't even allow yourself to meet people, get to know them, hang out with them or anything else because you're already thinking about what it may look like or feel like if you have to let them go or if they ghost you or let you go. Don't worry about the end. Try to be present. Sometimes you meet a person and you deal with them for a short period of time, but they're going to teach you something that you need to know and experience for you to go to the person that you will spend the rest of your life with, that you will grow old with. Stop running away from other people because all you're doing is running away from the mirror that shows you yourself. Hope. It says your loved ones in the spirit world know when to reach out if they see you're at a low point. Oh my God. Didn't I just say that? If you make a mistake and if you are divinely protected, if you make a mistake, your spirit team is going to reach in and help you. There is nothing to fear. If somebody is not for you, God will remove them. If you really have a relationship with God, your angels, your guides, your ancestors, whatever you truly believe in, pray to, whatever. If somebody is coming around you that's not supposed to be there, I'm telling you, they will be removed. I pray over my house in a way, nobody comes to my house. You can tell. When I start setting people that was coming, they can't come anymore. Their protection is at that door. You cannot get to me. Even if I don't see why, God knows why you don't need to be around me. And you have to walk in that confidence and that knowing. If that person is around me, they're supposed to be around me right now. Because God won't let certain people around me. My ancestors won't allow me to mess up our entire bloodline over a person.